God has been at work in our lives, offering healing and peace. Receive these gifts in the name of love of the Lord our God. Amen. Welcome. Good morning. Please stand for the call to worship. Waiting is never easy for us. Today, God is asking us to wait, to be patient. Quiet your spirit and open your hearts to God's words for you today. Lord, be with us. Help us to be ready to hear and respond to your word. Amen. Please be seated. We'll have praise and worship this morning by the Sanctuary Singers. And I shouldn't ask you to sit because, you know, praise and worship is a moment where we give God the thanks and the glory for yet another day in his presence. I'm going to ask you to stand again and let's worship God like nothing else.
There will be mountains that I would have to climb, and there will be battles that I would have to fight, but victory or defeat is up to me to decide. But how can I expect to win if I never try? I just can't give up now. I come too far, I come too far from where I started from. Nobody told me that don't believe He's brought me this far to lead me. Never said there would be trials. Never said I wouldn't fall. Never said that everything would go the way I want it to go. But when my back is against the wall and I feel our hope is gone, I just lift my hands up to the sky and help me to be strong. I just can't give up now. I've come too far from where I started from.
God is everything to them.
God is,
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 God
God is.
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 My everything.
God is.
God is.
My everything.
He's my joy.
He's my joy.
Let us pray. Lord of preparation and transition, we are already halfway through our summer months. We sit and wonder where the time went. Did we spend it well in your service? Give us these next few weeks for renewal that we may be prepared to work through your church for your world. Keep us mindful of the needs of families, friends, and others, that we will be your faithful disciples, for we ask these things in Jesus' name. Amen. We'll have another selection from the Sanctuary Singers.
Good morning.
Morning.
Morning. My hallelujah belongs to you. 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 You deserve it. You deserve it. You deserve it. You deserve it.
Taken from Matthew chapter 6, verse 9 through 13. Please stand for the gospel.
Amen. Let us share together in the reading of the gospel this morning. Jesus says, "Pray then in this way, Our Father in heaven, may your name be revered as holy. May your kingdom come. May your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our debts as we have forgiven our debtors. And do not bring us to the time of trial, but rescue us from the evil one. This is the gospel of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Amen.
Amen.
And you may be seated.
We'll have another selection from the Sanctuary Singers, and the next voice you hear is that of Reverend Andrea Davison with a message this morning, "Teach us to pray, thy will be done."
Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you. To see you high and lifted up, shining in the light of your glory. Pour out your power and love as we sing, holy, holy, holy.
Help me sing it.
Open the eyes.
Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I wanna see you.
Wanna see you.
I wanna see you.
Open the eyes, Lord.
Open the eyes of my heart, Lord.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Open the eyes of my heart.
Open the eyes of my heart, Lord.
praise God for our sanctuary singers this day. Amen. Amen. Praise God for that song, reminding us to continue to seek God, to open the eyes of our hearts that we indeed might behold the Lord. God is at work in our lives. Amen. God is moving in our midst, and sometimes we don't see that God is working. And so sometimes we have to ask God to open our eyes so that we can see that God's goodness and God's mercy are accompanying us, and that God is keeping us, and that God is healing, and God is making all things new. Amen. 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 As we prepare to break bread together and sharing in God's word, I invite you to join with me in a word of prayer. Holy God, for this day that you have made, we say thank you, and we honor you, and we glorify you. As Jesus taught us, we pray, Our Father, holy is your name. And so as the singers led us this day, we sing, Holy, holy, holy are you, Lord God. Holy is your name. We glorify you today, and we thank you once again for this time of worship. We pray, God, even as we reflect on this, your word, that you would continue to speak to us by your Holy Spirit, oh God, that we would hear what you have to say to us, that we would be strengthened in our faith, that we would be encouraged, oh God, where we might be downhearted, that we, oh God, our faith might be strengthened and firmly rooted in you, oh God, and that we will be able to bear witness to your love in the world. Be with us, we pray, in this preaching moment. In Christ's name, we pray. And all who are gathered said, Amen. 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 This is our second week as we are sharing in a sermon series entitled Teach Us to Pray. Teach Us to Pray. Last week we shared from the subject Our Father. We talked about the Lord's Prayer as a pattern for our prayer lives. Some of you will remember we talked about it being a conversation with God, and a conversation is not a monologue. Amen. A conversation is a dialogue, and so we share our praise and we share our concerns with God, but we also receive from the Lord. We receive in prayer God's mercy and forgiveness. We receive in prayer God's grace. Amen. We receive in prayer assurance that God is with us. And when we are in a dialogue, we are also listening to what God has to say to us. Our relationship with God is not just one with a far-off deity that is too great to be concerned about our concerns, but Jesus teaches us to pray, Our Father, our parent. God loves us and wants to be in relationship with us and cares about you and I. Amen? And Jesus teaches us not only to come before God as Abba, Father, but also to reverence God's name, as we have done this morning, declaring, Holy is your name, God. Righteous is your name. So today we're going to look at the next part of the Lord's Prayer. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. What is God's kingdom? When Jesus first started his ministry, he announced, the kingdom of God is at hand. Yes? So when we use the word kingdom, we often reference a place or an area or a geographical or political boundary. But the Greek word for kingdom in the Bible puts the emphasis on the rule or the reign of the king rather than the place that the king is reigning. And in fact, some translations of this phrase basileia, those of you who have studied your Bible a little bit, meaning the kingdom, the basileia of God in the New Testament Greek, translated the reign of God or the rule of God. So Jesus comes announcing that God's kingdom, meaning God's rule or God's reign, is here on earth. It is in God's kingdom there is peace. Amen. Where God's reign, the oppressed get justice, amen? Under God's rule, the hungry are fed, the marginalized are respected, the sick are healed, because God is Abba, Father, but God is also King. God reigns over all. That means that God, the parent that rules over the heavens, also reigns over the earth, that reigns over all of us. So if God is King, then you and I are King's kids. Amen? You and I are sons and daughters of royalty. Amen? And so we're citizens. Some of us are citizens of the United States of America, some of us of other countries, but more importantly, we are citizens of the kingdom of God, the reign of God. So because we love God as our Heavenly Father, we want to see God's reign show up here on earth. We want to see the love of God and the peace of God and the mercy and the justice of God show up in God's people. And so if this is our desire to see God's kingdom come, then my job is to pray and to work that God's kingdom be fully realized on earth. Amen? My question to you is, what is your image of what it'll look like when God's kingdom ultimately comes? What do you have in mind when you pray, thy kingdom come, thy will be done? Well, Pastor, why is this important? Well, when you pray, if you don't have an image in mind of what you're asking for, then they can be just words, amen? But it's important because what you think about God's kingdom coming shapes your behavior in the present one. It impacts how we live our lives right now. If we believe that God is a God of justice, then you and I will work towards promoting justice. Amen? If we believe that God's kingdom coming means caring for the poor and making sure that the hungry are fed and those who need clothing have clothes, and we're going to participate in missions for the poor that ensure that they're fed and they're clothed, amen? So God's work of salvation, God's kingdom coming, is not partial. It is holistic. We serve a God that wants us to be whole, not fractured. Amen? And that means that when God saves our souls, God doesn't save just our souls and leave out the rest of us. When God's kingdom comes, when God's reign is at work in our lives, we are saved spiritually, yes, but we also experience God's saving power emotionally. We experience God's saving power physically so that we have good health and we have enough strength to do what God is calling us to do. When we experience God's saving power in our lives, we know God's saving power financially in our pocketbook so that we can pay our bills, amen, and keep a roof over our head. Hallelujah, somebody. It is important to know what you're praying for when you ask, thy kingdom come, thy will be done. It means that any condition that does not reflect God's shalom, the well-being of all of creation, when we say your kingdom come, we're praying that God's saving power would move into that area so that they also would be saved. This is exactly what Dr. Martin Luther King had in mind when he stood on the steps of Lincoln Memorial on August 28, 1963. It was a march on Washington, y'all will remember. And he spoke to folks there, but he spoke prophetically, imagining, helping them to see what the kingdom of God looks like. He was helping them to see what the reign of God will look like, helping them to dream and to live into what it will be when God's kingdom comes. His image of God's reign, he says, I have a dream that one day this nation will rise up and live out the true meaning of its creed. We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal. He says, I have a dream that one day on the red hills of Georgia, the sons of former slaves and the sons of former slave owners will be able to sit down together at the table of brotherhood. Can you see the image of what it looks like when God's kingdom comes? He says, I have a dream that one day the state of Mississippi will be transformed into an oasis of freedom and justice. I have a dream that my four little children will one day live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. He says, I have a dream today. I have a dream that one day down in Alabama, little black boys and black girls will be able to join hands with little white boys and white girls as sisters and brothers. Can you see the image of what it looks like for Dr. King when God's kingdom comes and God's will is done on earth? He says, I have a dream today that one day every valley shall be exalted and every hill and mountain shall be made low. The rough places will be made plain and the crooked places will be made straight. And the glory of the Lord shall be revealed and all flesh shall see it together. That's good news, somebody. He is imaging. For those who listened on that day, and we many years later, I wasn't even alive when he made that speech. Hallelujah. But he is helping us to see what it looks like when God's kingdom comes on earth. And so when we have this image of what God we're seeking for God to do, we can begin to pray earnestly towards what that will look like. And so we're asking that God's kingdom come to pass, and then we begin to work with God towards that coming to pass as well. So our prayers become a part of what God uses to transform the world so that our hearts are turned towards what God's desire is for us. And then through those prayers, we begin to assist God in building up God's kingdom here on earth. That we too begin to echo the words of the prophets. Like the prophet Amos said, let justice roll down like a river and righteousness like a never-failing stream. Thy kingdom come, will be done. Now praying for God's will also provides a foundation for our prayers. We're asking that God's will be done in our lives and that God's will be done around us. Sometimes, I don't know about you, but sometimes I get it in reverse. Sometimes I pray as if I expect God to do my will rather than the other way around. But when we pray, thy will be done, we are surrendering to God's will. We have to be cautious about being more interested in our personal kingdom rather than God's kingdom. Amen? That's why Jesus said, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. It's important that we not just seek our way, but also we are seeking God's way, not just our dreams and our desires without checking in to see if they align with God's dream and God's desire for our lives. Even Jesus, when he went to the Garden of Gethsemane and he prayed, Father, if you're willing, take this cup from me, yet not my will, but your will be done. Jesus knew that if the Father's will was ever to come to pass, then he would have to submit his will to God's will. And so, Christians, this is part of Christian spiritual maturity, that sometimes we need to learn to trust God enough to say, I know what I want, but I trust that God's will is perfect for my life, and I'm willing to submit to God's will for my life. Amen? Jesus said, for I have come down from heaven not to do my will, but to do the will of him who sent me. So when we pray, thy will be done, we're asking for God's will to be done. And sometimes it goes along with our will, but sometimes we have to surrender our will to God's will. So remember, prayer is not about us making God do anything. Prayer is about you and I aligning our hearts and our will with God's heart and God's will so that we're able to trust the Lord enough to say, thy will be done. So if you get sick, if you lose your job, if you're struggling, if you're suffering, if you feel abandoned or betrayed, you know, in the middle of it all, you can say, God is going to handle this. God is going to fix it. I know that this is not the end because I know that God's will is being done. And I know that in the end, God is working it all out for my good. Amen. So God, I will receive what is your will for my life because I know that your will for my life is perfect. I know that God is a good God, that God looks down with compassion and love for us as his children, and that God has a future with hope for us. Had Jesus not prayed that he, not my will, but thy will be done, he may not have gone to the cross. Amen, church. He would never have atoned for our sins, and we'd all find ourselves possibly going to hell. Amen. It's a good thing, church, that we pray, your will be done, because I love you, God, and I trust you, and I accept that what you have is not just for me, but what you're doing might be for somebody else as well. Thy will be done. As I close, prayer is not so much about making God do something as it is about transforming our hearts. And so there's a saying that says, those who pray, they change. They're transformed. Some people don't pray because they don't want change. Amen. Some people don't pray because they're afraid what God might do might not be what they want. Amen. So those who pray biblically change. So trust that when we pray, we are trusting that God hears us and God is going to move. And God will move in our life and our situations, but God will also move in our hearts. And so this is our prayer when we worship the Lord. God, I trust you. God, I will surrender to you. God, I will honor you with my life because I trust that you are good and that I trust that your will is perfect. So first, we pray a prayer of adoration. Father, Abba, holy is your name. Thank you for what you've done for us. Thank you for who God is. And second, we pray this prayer of worship. Trusting God, thy kingdom come, thy will be done in our lives. And that begins with my life. Amen. I know y'all praying for other folks that God will save them. I know y'all praying for other folks down the street that God will move in their life. But first, when we pray thy kingdom come, we're praying first, Lord, let your kingdom come in me. Do that work in me first. We're praying for God's kingdom to come, trusting that work that God is doing, that God will begin first in us, but that God will do in the world. And so we pray, thy kingdom come, will be done. You hear that as good news. Somebody say hallelujah and amen. Amen. I'm going to invite our sanctuary singers to lead us in a song of response. And as they come, if there's one today, I don't know everybody in here yet, but if there's one that has never given their life to Jesus Christ, Jesus bids us to come and have a relationship with God as your Father. Amen. But also to know that God saves and God sent his son Jesus Christ to save you from your sins. Amen. Amen. So if there's one that has never said, not my will, but thy will be done. If there's one that's never said, I give my life to you, Jesus. I want to invite you to come today and surrender to Jesus Christ and say yes. If there's one that does not have a church home, I want you to consider that God might be leading you to be a part of North United Methodist Church. And as we sing our hymn today, I invite you to come down and say yes to God's call.
Come to Jesus.
Come to Jesus. Come to Jesus.
Just come to Jesus.
Come to Jesus.
Just now. He will save you.
He will save you. He will save you. Just now.
In prayer. Gracious and loving God, we thank you, O God, that you continue to be our Father. We thank you, O God, that we are your sons and daughters. We thank you, O God, that you care for us and you love us, O God. We praise you now, O God, because you continue to provide for our needs according to your riches and glory. We thank you, O God, because you're a good Father, O God. You have compassion upon your children, O God, and you bid us to come to seek your face. You bid us to come before your throne, O God. You promised if we would call on you, you would answer. And so we come before you even now, God. We thank you, O God, for this sweet hour of prayer. We thank you, O God, for the opportunity, O God, to worship you, O God, even in this time of prayer. And we declare, O God, that you are holy. We declare that you are righteous. We declare that you are worthy of our praise, O God. And so before we ask for a single thing, God, we just want to worship you, Lord God. We just want to acknowledge, O God, that you are our source, O God, that you are our Savior, O God, that you are our provider, that you are our healer, that you are our everything, O God. And so it is because you are faithful, O God, that we call on you now in prayer. We come before you, O God, and we acknowledge, O God, that there are many needs in this house. And so we ask, God, that you would attend to your children's needs, O God. You hear your children's cries, O God. You know, O God, what they stand in need of. So even now, God, we pray in the name of Jesus, where there is a need for a healing touch, O God, we pray for good health, oh God. We pray that you would restore your children's strength, Lord God. We pray that you would lift us up when we fall down, Lord God. We pray that you would be a lifter of our head, Lord God. We pray that you would encourage hearts and minds, Lord God. We pray, Lord God, that you would grant us what we need, that we might persevere in running the race that is set before us, Lord God. In the name of Jesus, we come before you now, oh God. There are some that stand in need of provision, oh God. I pray in Jesus' name that you will open doors that no one can shut. I pray in Jesus' name, oh God, that you would open the windows of heaven and pour out a blessing, oh God, that there would not be room enough to receive it in Jesus' name. Oh God, I pray now that you would bless families, bless homes, oh God. I pray that you would restore relationships in Jesus' name, oh God. I pray that you would continue, oh God, to let love abide, let peace abide, let joy abide, oh God, in these families and in their homes, in Jesus' name. God, we trust you with our lives, oh God. We trust you with our concerns, oh God. And we trust, Lord God, that you are able to do everything but fail. And so we call on you now, God, and we pray, oh God, that you would intervene, oh God, as only you can, oh God. Yes, sir. And make things right, oh God. Make things new. In the name of Jesus, we pray. We lift up not only ourselves, God, but we lift up our community that we're in. We lift up, oh God, our nation and this world that you so love. We pray not only for ourselves, oh God, but we pray for one another, oh God, and we pray that your kingdom will come. We pray that your will be done, not only in our lives, oh God, but in this world. We need you, Lord. We need you, Lord, and so we thank you, God. We thank you, God, that you hear us and you attend to our needs now. And so we say hallelujah, and we say thank you, God, for hearing and answering our prayers. We pray together this prayer as Jesus taught his disciples. We pray, our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Jesus, Jesus, how I trust.
Jesus, precious Jesus,
Reverend Davidson, for that beautiful sermon. I know I learn more and more from you each week. To God be the glory. We'll move on to tithes and offering this morning. As usual, there's three ways for tithes and offering. We'll have the online version of e-offer, and then you could always mail it in. And then this morning, you could always turn it in the plate collection. Let us pray. Lord, receive our gifts and our lives. Cause all of these blessings to work for you in this world, which you have loaned to us for safekeeping. In Christ's name, we pray. Amen.
Bring sacrifice of praise into the house
of the Lord. We bring sacrifice of praise into the house of the Lord. And we offer up to you the sacrifices of thanksgiving. And we offer up to you the sacrifices of praise.
We bring
the sacrifice of praise into the house of the Lord. We bring the sacrifice of praise into the house of the Lord. And we offer up to you the sacrifices of thanksgiving. And we offer up to you the sacrifices of joy.
We bring
the sacrifice of praise into the house of the Lord.
Oh,
we bring the sacrifice of praise into the house of the Lord.
Please stand for the doxology.
Praise God from all blessings. Praise Him, O creature.
Gracious God, we thank you for the gift and everyone that has given. We pray your blessings upon each one now, O God, that you would continue to pour out, O God, into their lives, that they might know your abundance and they might be able to share out of that abundance, not only with your church, O God, but it within the world as well. Bless these gifts, God, that they might be used for the upbuilding of your kingdom here on earth. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Good to be in the house of God today. And as Reverend Davidson continued with her series of service sermons this month, I hope you bring a friend next week and the week after so that they can all learn how to pray and look at the Lord's Prayer differently. So I'm hoping you could bring a friend or a family member next week. Let us continue with a selection from the Sanctuary Singers, and then we'll move into benediction.
Anybody got a grateful heart this morning? Wait, hold on. Does anybody have a grateful heart this morning? We just want to give grace and thanks to God for what he's done to us, for us. Amen?
Amen.
Great.
send you forth with this benediction. Go forth with joy, celebrating all the many ways for us to serve our Lord. Give us courage, hope, peace, and love that we might bear these gifts to others. Go in peace. And the people of God said, amen.
Amen.
Amen. God bless you. Have a great week.